This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about Euler paths and Euler circuits. So let's see what this is about. Over here, I've drawn a graph or a network, and it consists of these small circles. These are called vertices or nodes, and the nodes are connected by lines. The lines are called edges or arcs. Now, if I can start at one of the nodes, let's say over here, and travel on every single one of the edges, only one time on each edge, but on every single one, then we say that I've got a traversable network or an Euler path. If on top of doing that, I end up at exactly the same node I started on, then we say I've got an Euler circuit. So one of the questions we ask about networks is that network an Euler path or an Euler circuit or neither? So to understand this, let's start with a really simple network with an Euler path. So I'm going to draw two nodes. This node over here, I'm going to call the start node. And another node over here, that's going to be the finish. And to make a network out of this, I'll connect those two nodes. And now I've got a traversable network. I've got an Euler path. I've got a place where I'm starting. I travel along all of the edges. There's only one edge. And I get to the finish node. So I've had a traversable network, I've had an Euler path. It's not an Euler circuit because I didn't get back to where I started, but it's an Euler path. Now, let's make this a little more complicated. Let's say that instead of going directly from the start to the finish, I add another node. Now, when I add that other node, look what happens. That node is going to have two edges at it, one where I arrived at it and one where I left it. That's different than the start and the finish. The start and the finish only have one edge. For the start node, I left and I never came back. So all I needed was one edge. For the finish node, I arrived at it and never left. So all I needed was one edge. For any nodes in between along that path, I'm going to have an edge that gets me there and then another edge that leaves. Okay, so what I want to do is keep track of how many edges we have at each of the nodes as we make this more and more complicated. Now, let's say that instead of going directly to the finish, after I get to this third node here, I decide to go back. I go back to the start. So this third node still has two edges, one where I arrived at it and one where I leave it. The start node now has two edges because I left it the first time and then I came back to it. But I want to get to the finish node, so I have to leave that start node again. Now the start node is going to have three edges. I get to the finish node and the finish node has one edge. Now notice that the finish node and the start node now have an odd number of edges. This makes sense. Because in the case of the finished node, I get there only once, and I never leave it again. In the case of the start node, I leave it, but then after that, I come back and leave. So I leave it, that's one edge, and then coming back and leaving is two more edges, so that's an odd number. Let's say I don't go directly back to the finished node. Let's say that after leaving the start the second time, I go over to this node here. This node now has three edges because I arrived at it the first time and then left it and then I got back to it again. But I have to get to the finish, so I have to leave it another time. Now it's going to have four edges. And the finish node will once again only have one edge. Okay, so let's see what's going on here. For the start node and for the finish node, I've got an odd number of edges. This makes sense because in the case of the start node, I leave, and then if I come back, I have to leave again. If I came back another time, I would have to leave again. So coming back and leaving are always going to give me an even number. But the start that I had is an odd number. It's just one time where I started. So I'm going to always have an odd number of edges if I start here and end up leaving. The finish is always going to have an odd number of edges. If I leave it, let's say I leave it over to here and then come back to it again so I can finish, it will still have an odd number of edges. All of the other nodes will have an even number of edges. This has 2, this one has 6. Because since they're neither start nor finish, it means I arrive at them and leave them the same number of times. Each time I arrive, I also leave. So arriving and leaving give me 2 more edges each time that happens. So that's always going to be an even number of edges. So from this, we can get a basic rule. The rule is going to say this, that to have a traversable network or an Euler path, what I'm going to have is all of the nodes will have an even number of edges, except for the start and the finish. They can have an even number, and I'll talk about that in a second. But if we start at one point and finish at another point and have an Euler path, then we're going to have odd numbers of edges at both the start and the finish. Now, what if instead of finishing where I did, I go back to the start one more time and stop there? So now the start and the finish are the same place. Well, the old finish node now has an even number of edges because each time I came there, each time I arrived at it, I left it again. The start node, which is also now the finish node, has an even number of edges because every time I left it, I came back to it. And all of the other nodes also have an even number of edges. So now what I've done is I've taken an Euler path and I've connected the finish with the start and turned it into an Euler circuit. Okay, so for an Euler circuit, you have to have all of the nodes with an even number of edges. If you have an Euler circuit, you can start at any node you want, travel on all the edges, and end up back where you started. Okay, they all have to have an even number of edges. If you have all of the nodes with an even number of edges, except for 2 of them, if those 2 have an odd number of edges, then you no longer have an Euler circuit, but you still have an Euler path. Those 2 nodes with the odd numbers of circuits, odd numbers of edges, are going to be the start and the finish. Okay, so that's about how this works. Take care. I'll see you next time.